Hi everybody, thanks for joining us. I'm Rhonda.
And I'm Annie, and even though Rhonda and I are good friends, we are staying 6 feet apart to respect social distancing.
So today we're going to talk about animal movements. Animals move for a few different reasons, either to find other animals, find their own species, find food, find water or shelter, and they move in lots of different ways to be able to do that. But before we meet some animals and find out the ways that they move, Annie's going to talk to us about how people move.
Humans move in lots of different ways for similar purposes as animals. One way that we move as humans is by walking. And to walk, we use our legs and our feet to go find what we need. We can also use our arms and our hands to do things like eating, writing, and picking things up. So let's meet some animals today that move in different ways than humans do. This is Hopscotch, and he is one of our crested geckos. He comes from the island of New Caledonia, which is off the coast of Australia, and he's not found anywhere else in the world. And as you can see, he's moving in ways that I am not able to. He's a very good climber. He has tiny little hairs on his toe pads that allow him to climb up something even like very smooth glass like he is in here. He lives way up in the tops of trees to keep him safe from predators. And as you can see, he moves his tongue a whole lot. He has little scales over his eyes that allow his eyeballs to be protected, but that also means he doesn't have true eyelids, so he's not able to blink to get things out of his eyes. So if you look closely, you may see him actually using his tongue to lick his eyeball to clean it, which is something I don't do either.
So Annie, when I'm looking at Hopscotch, it seems like there's something on the end of his tail. What would that be?
You're right, there is right now. So Hopscotch, being a gecko, is a reptile, and reptiles shed their skin. Hopscotch is just finishing up that process, but you'll see there is a little bit of his shed attached to his tail. In the next couple minutes, that'll come off, and that's completely normal for geckos.
So geckos usually grow for almost their whole life. A lot of reptiles do that. So as they grow, they need to have their skin be larger for them to be able to fit into it properly. Kind of like when you grow, you have to buy bigger clothes. So since Hopscotch is shedding off his skin, it means he's a tiny bit bigger than he was a few days ago.
And to help him grow, he does have to eat lots and lots of food. And Hopscotch, along with other crested geckos, are omnivores. They do eat some bugs and some meat sources, but they do also eat lots of fruits and vegetables and vegetation. Hopscotch's favorite food is bananas.
So let's go over some of the movements that we learned that Hopscotch does. So one of them is to climb, and the other one is to lick his eyeball to clean it since he doesn't have eyelids. So if you want, you can join me at home and do some of the movements. So Hopscotch can climb, and he can climb up really slippery surfaces because of those ridges on his feet.
Hopscotch also uses his tongue to lick his eyeball clean. Can your tongue reach your eyeball? Let's try. Does it work for you, Rhonda?
Not really.
It doesn't work for me either, but it's a good thing Hopscotch can. Now that we've moved like a gecko, let's put Hopscotch away and meet our next animal.
Our next animal is Ernie the Duck. Ernie is a domestic mallard duck, which means that his body is double the size of the ducks you see flying around outside, but his wings are still really small like those ducks. So Ernie actually can't fly because his body is too big for his wings. But normally, you're gonna see ducks being able to fly outside. And ducks fly so that they can migrate, which means moving to areas with warmer weather. And they also fly to be able to get food and to go to the places that they need to find water and shelter. Ernie also goes in fresh water. So that means like rivers and streams and ponds. And he likes to do that to be able to swim. And you can see that ducks have webbed feet. So if you look between your fingers, do you have anything in there? Not really. So they have webbing, which means skin in between their toes. And when they have that, it allows them to swim through the water and push themselves through the water. So that makes it so ducks can swim to get away from predators or to find fish to eat or to find different bugs that they can find on the water to eat.
Now that we've learned how ducks move, such as flying to help them migrate and stay safe from predators and swimming to help them find their food, let's move like ducks.
Is everybody ready to fly? All right, so we can fly around to migrate.
Fly around to find food.
Ernie, do you want to fly with us?
And we can use our feet, like Ernie does, to swim. Although we don't have webbed feet, so we wouldn't be very good swimmers like Ernie.
We can try, though.
If you've done these movements with us today, post pictures and videos in the comments below to show us how great you can move.
And make sure you keep an eye out for next week for the second half of Animal Movements, where you'll get to meet two more of our ambassador animals and learn how they can move.
Bye.